Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. I'm gonna play another Mirage Block Draft. I haven't had time to play enough of these. But, so this might be the last one. But if I win it, or do well, I will probably play another. The Visions boosters are hard to come by. I just bought one for 5 tickets. That felt really wrong. Okay, I hope sound is good. I'm recording in the apartment, whereas I usually record in the villa. Or I recorded the earlier one for this. Hope they are firing as well. No person in the queue. Might have undervalued the dream cache in the first draft. And I will be looking for dream caches now. I will now pause and rehearse from Florian's great article on Pure MTGO. Okay, so the plan is to cut blue and look for some other color. I really should have been blue black in the first draft. And I just did not do what I was supposed to do. Here we go. Oh, goldfish should be up. Goldfish will tell me that Aifa Groove is crap. It is. Oh, Savage Twister is one of the strongest cards in the set. So I guess I'll be the dreaded red green deck. It's a gold card. You never ever pass it. Not sure. I'm not sending any strong red or green signal here. So this is my Savage Twister deck. Fun, I'll go against my own wisdom again, maybe. Or maybe taking a gold card first is really bad because I might not play it. Stupid bottle. Already bored by reading it. Flare is not what I want. Beasting is not what I want. How good is Beasting? Salamander Infantry. What the hell? Is there anything playable in this pack? Flare or Beasting? Nothing real blue anyway. I'm taking the Flare then. Second pick Flare feels great. Okay. Looking for Enlightened Tutor, Lionside Diamond, Mystical Tutor, Phyrexian Dreadnought, Worldly Tutor. We'll also pick Shellgrave, Cerulean of the Claw, Flash. Over anything else. Here's Decomposition. Okay. Stupid Golem Mine Hardness. Not too shabby. And nothing red green. Sandbar Crocodile. These are some great blue cards. So we are now getting the blue signal we wanted and switching to blue. Feral Shadow is not bad. Crocodile or Mind Harness. Taking the control magic. Firewalker! Minotaur is decent, but I am now going blue. Firewalker seems strong. Stupid Serpent. Merfolk Raiders, not the best. The Golem is playable in any deck, actually. Seeds of Innocence. What the hell? I never seen that card. Is it worth anything? Oh, look cool. Can't tell what the casting cost is. Is it just three? Oh, okay, so we're taking the golem. Wave elemental, 4 for 2, 3. Not too good. Dream Fighter is okay. Oh. Blue, red, splashing, Savage Twister, maybe. Blue cards keep coming. Benevolent Unicorn was once a money card, but it isn't anymore. And I'll just go with the Dream Fighter, who will hold the ground for me all day while my awesome Visions cards win the match, where I will get all the blue stuff. My undoes, my flyers, my Man of Wars, they will come to me in Visions. And I might be blue-red, which is of course not the best. Such awful, awful cards. I don't know what to pick here. I really want to play my Savage Twister, maybe too much. We shall see. Teferi's Curse. Weird bottle. Such horrible, horrible crap. Nine barely playables. Is Elite Infantry playable? Not really, no. Raiders or the Serpent? Raiders. Sore? Probably not to be played. Teferi's Curse, absolutely not to be played. Visions! Looking for Desertion, Natural Order, Crypt Rats. We're not looking for Lightning Cloud, we never play Cosmic Red Order. Oh. That's interesting. But there is an undo in this pack. And I will just pick it up. Florian says, Man of War, Breezekeeper, Cloud Elemental, Knight of the Mists. And yes, we do need creatures. Sands of Time. Well, they are not useful. Goblin Recruiter. He is 92 cents. Oh, Man of War. How beautiful are you? Well, we need flyers. Teferi's Realm. Weird. Vision Charm is not what you want it to be. Harsh Charm is not either. Gossamer Chains, pretty good. Vultures is the power card here. This card is not useful for us. The hell? Unless we happen to end up in blue-green splashing red instead. In that case could be very useful. Can soar the bull elephant. Ah. Focus. We need our blue strategy to pay off more. And this is the fourth pick here. So we're not gonna see any of the money cards. Kervex Spite. It's so crazy. Another undo. So now we're really speaking blue-green here, because now we would really benefit from a force on the ground. Could splash two red for Savage Twister and Ifrit. Not play the flare and go green here. So that, in that case we need some green fat. Watch the Savage Twister Firewalker combo. So what are we getting in the last pack? Quicksand, always reliable. Knight of the Mists. Or Warthog. I think we are taking Knight of the Mists. Helm of Awakening used to be on the money list, but it's no longer because it has fallen in price. So we are taking the Caterpillar. Speaking of the green fat here. Panther Warriors is not the worst. And an impulse to sort things out would be nice here. More creatures, definitely. So we were still looking at what we are going to get in Weatherlight. Oh, green and blue are the two worst colors in Weatherlight. That sucks. Vampirism. Shrieking Drake. Elven Cash. Walker. Can you play the orangutan? It's somewhat dangerous, as I do have an artifact. Everglades. Okay, I'll read that later. Juju Bubble, Karoo. Solfatar of Vision Charm. Don't know. It's all crap. So what do I do against, like, creatures? I bounce them. A Vanishing must be the stronger card here. But it's so mana intensive. Where are my flyers? I don't have any flyers. Okay, so now we're only gonna get really crappy Weatherlight cards. Looking for Doomsday and Nullrod. Serenity, Winding Canyons, Lotus Whale, Goblin Bomb, Gemstone Mine, Firestorm, Abeyance. This guy I can play. Fogelmentor was okay, but I think Arboroth is better. Though I am definitely not sure. Bright Shield is okay as well. So I'm blue, green, splashing red for stuff. And I'm no, I'm not playing the ring. Dreamfighter seems so bad. I don't really have much evasion. Do I have to play this sword? Phantom Warrior. I'm taking the Phantom Warrior here, of course. Apathy, Sage Hold, Tranquil Grow. I thought that was a money card. It's 33 cents. Redwood Tree Folk is okay, isn't it? Ooh, Spinning Darkness. How deep have we fallen, Spinning Darkness? 81 cents, that's not good enough. I'm gonna have a Tree Folk. Manta Ray, Mana Chains. Striped Bears. Striped Bears will just clog the ground further, but it will keep me going, so let's take them. Psychic Watch, Manta Ray, Disrupt. Nature's Kiss. Interesting. Vortex, nothing to write home about. Is Manta Ray that bad? Probably. We are to 25. Wave of Terror. Disrupt. More stupid bears. What? He becomes a flyer. Wow, it cost a ton of mana. I want cards rather than that. Plus 0, plus 3, and has reach. That doesn't seem very good. It seems like a sideboard card. Gotta start cutting things here. And I think I need a red splash. Actually. Mind Harness will be a powerful sideboard card. Hello, Mr. Tolarian Drake. Ancestral Knowledge. What? Okay, I'm taking the flyer. flux for the flood. Oh, fog elemental. Merfolk Raiders moves to the sideboard. I just hate drafting at this point. But I have plenty of playables. So much, in fact, that I need to cut something. So what about vanishing? Maybe Vanishing is a sideboard card. Yeah, cut all the cheap stuff. 24 cards and I need to get down to 22. Undo, undo. Firewalker, Phantom Warrior, Talarian Drake, Man of War, Knight of Mist, Fog Elemental, Flux, Dreamfighter, Dreamfighter. Or one Dreamfighter in the sideboard. Against the huge guys on the ground. That could be a thing. Huge guy, huge guy. Semi huge guy. Somewhat huge guy. Three, four, trample. Not impressed. Where the hell are all my cards that I felt that I had to include in the deck? Impulse seems good. 16 creatures. Manta Ray. Sideboard against blue, maybe. It's not like I have too few 3 drops. I'm gonna bring in the Merfolk Raiders to have something to do earlier in the game. This looks really good, actually. I'm gonna run with 2 mountains and trust on my flux and my impulse to get to my 2 red cards, and also trust that they are powerful enough for this. Nothing costs double green. Plenty of stuff costs double blue. This seems too dangerous. So 18 lands, flux. Undo, undo. Pretty giant twister. It will be hard to cast this twister. I need 2 of those lands. And I only have 8. So on average, I will have 2 of the lands on turn 3, but they are not necessarily mountains. And the only way I have to find it is flux and... Not sure. Not sure at all. Tell me what you would have done differently. What pick you would have done differently. And we're off to the races. Should I have let go of my bombs? Probably not.